Google Mail filters allow you to manage the flow of incoming messages. Filters are similar to rules within Outlook. Using filters, you can automatically label, archive, delete, star, or forward your mail, even keep it out of spam. It's all based on a combination of keyword, sender, recipient, and more. To create a filter, click the Create a Filter link. Enter your filter criteria in the appropriate fields. I'm looking for messages from judith@netmanners.com. I get a daily mailing about net etiquette from her. Clicking Test Search will show all of the messages currently in my Google mailbox that match my filter terms. If you're not getting the results you expected, you can update your criteria and run another test search. I'm happy with what's shown up, so I'm going to go ahead and click Next Step. Now, I can select one or more of the actions from this list. These actions will be applied to messages matching my filter criteria in the order in which the actions are listed. For these particular messages, I don't want them to show up in my inbox. They will automatically be archived, and they will have the label mailing list applied to it. Then during my lunch hour, I can just read through all of my mailing list messages. I'd like to apply this filter to messages already in Google Mail, so I'll select Also Apply Filters to the 11 conversations below. Then I'll click Create Filter to create this filter. Now, messages from judith@netmanners skip the inbox and have the mailing list label applied. If I'd like to read those messages, I can just click on my mailing list label to see those messages. Has the words is another useful filter criteria. I'm working on a project called the Groundhog Shadow Day Project, and we have a new team member, and so I'd like to forward all of my messages I have about this project to that team member. So I'll go ahead and search for messages that have the word groundhog. I'll do a test search. About three messages come up. Then from next step, I'll choose to forward all of these messages to my new team member. I'll apply it to the three conversations below and click Create the Filter. Once he's caught up to speed and on the appropriate mailing list for this project, I could then probably delete this filter.